patriotic past, in the far past, and now in the near past. We would like the country to be reminded that this country has gone through state-sponsored problems. The economy, social destabilization, and it's historical. Many will remember the zero option. Many will remember the black number. All these things, in our view, we think that was state-sponsored. When the state starts to run out of ideas, they also start to do an orthodox things. All right? Now, we think that we must also remind the country that at the time when there were fires all over the country, specifically Lusaka City Market, Mrs. Wina, the vice president of this country, made a very reckless statement, which up to this day, she has failed to substantiate. If you do recall, she said, what kind of people are these in UPND who can go to such lengths? As things stand today, the police have failed to give a forensic investigation to come up with a conclusive statement as to how and what caused those fires. But the president, the vice president, in her wisdom, decided to dart out a reckless statement which is failed to prove. Last week, the Minister of Lands, if you do recall, made a very, very incompetent point of order on the floor of Parliament. And fortunately, the Speaker of the National Assembly rose to the occasion and actually categorized that point of order as an incompetent point of order, because she was insinuating that because of the troubles that are going on in our society, people were chanting UPND single. Obviously, who doesn't know that we are going into an election in the next few months? Who does not know that? Who does not know that people have started aligning themselves to parties of their choice? Who does not know that? But Mrs. Kapata was insinuating that the trouble that happened in Mandevu with the constituents was being sponsored. And now we can see that they are building up their story. Mr. Chanda also has been granting carpeting in the corridors of what they call it, interactive forum, insinuating silly things. The police, this is your call, to make sure that you do a professional job, to make sure that your investigations are forensic, to make sure that you are targeting the problem where it is, and not to simply listen to people who dream out of Chiluvi. After beating up people, they come and say, I've had this information for 5 years. Isn't that espionage? Isn't that subversiveness? If you can hold information that is detrimental to a country, you hold it for 5 years. Really, it means you're a very irresponsible individual. And it should be known as such, because anything that threatens national sovereignty should be the duty of every citizen to bring it straight to the arms of the law. Why should Mr. Mwamba hold on to this information for 5 years? A question must be answered. The police must go and ask him, why have you been holding on to this information for 5 years? And anybody who becomes aware of the subversion becomes an accomplice if he does not report that matter to the police. Okay? Now, finally, we also heard